Yeah. This is a... What's this, today October 30th? Yeah, so today is Devil's Night. Child Sacrifice Night, Trick or Treat Night. There you go. What's up, y'all? We out here on, out here in Columbus, Ohio. You know what I'm saying? We about to preach the truth of the Holy Bible. We coming in the name of Yahalabah, Shem Yahawashai. And we gonna prophesy the downfall of America. Y'all know America is prophesied to be destroyed. Yeah, that's a big joke, ain't it? Big weirdo. Yeah, but tonight is October 30th in Columbus. This is Trick or Treat Night. This is the night when all these single adulterous whores, all these whores women take their little bastard children out to go trick or treating. And they so stupid, they gonna take their kids and dress them up like witches and goblins. And they gonna go trick or treat, and they gonna get some sperm candy and some butthole candy. You know what I mean? They got all these homosexuals and faggots out here. They love the homosexual and the faggot and the devil worshiper. They love Halloween and they love trick or treat night because they get to take your candy and they be jacking off on the candy.
But little guy across the street.
Huh?
Little guy walking across the street.
Yeah, right.
What?
They stick the candy
right
up
there
in their asshole.
Oh, that is it.
He's too tall. Oh, yeah, that's good.
So in Amos 9 and 8. Behold, the eyes of the Lord's power are upon the sinful kingdom, and I will destroy it from off the face of the earth.
Yeah, and America is the most sinful kingdom upon the face of the earth. Like I said, in America, it's legal for a man to marry a man. It's okay for faggots to get married. In America, there's no Sabbath. There's, you know what I'm saying? There's no day of rest. Mm. It's legal for women to commit adultery, to leave their husband, take their children away from them. It's legal to worship the devil in America. They just had a satanic ceremony over there in Oklahoma. Y'all know America is the kingdom of Satan. Did you know America is the kingdom of Satan? That's why the Lord is going to destroy America. All right? And all you faggots with it. That's what's gonna happen.
Did I stutter?
What they say? Who say? Say something?
Ugly redhead bitch.
Yeah. Ugly ginger bitch.
I hear them eat a bunch of ginger. We don't match.
There goes your homie.
Oh shit, there go Esau. He ain't gotta dress up for trick or treat night. What's up, homie?
Esau's natural state.
Got some vinyl.
Yeah, he got them vinyls. He ready to go dance with his old lady.
And I will destroy it from off the face of the earth, saving that I will not utterly destroy the house of Jacob, said the Lord.
Yeah, so the Lord, he gonna destroy 2/3 of Israel. Like we just, right before we got out here, we was talking about Russia and how Russia is testing all kind of missiles, right? And soon, Russia's gonna just start raining missiles on America. Because they've been flying bombers and jet fighters over all kind of NATO countries, taunting all these NATO countries, taunting America. They taunting Sweden. They got a nuclear submarine off the coast of Sweden. Talking, saying, well, I dare you to do something.
Damn.
Now, yeah, I'm going to zoom in on some motherfuckers.
Get the motherfuckers on camera.
It was probably me.
That motherfucker looked like Ozzy Osbourne.
Right. Acting like a look at that. Them
was
probably men.
Probably are. Men. Fucking weirdos, man.
Fucking disgrace, man. A goddamn disgrace. It's an abomination, these motherfuckers out here. Look at them. Should be a fucking shame of themselves. Wayne, these people ain't got no shame. Shame has been wiped out.
Because Conan O'Brien.
Shame has been wiped the fuck out.
But the Lord, hey, get, we can go back to that destruction. Let's get Zechariah 14 melted away. You know what I want. Because, yeah, they acting all proud and evil right now. You have men dressing up as women.
Look at that shit, man.
Get them on camera. The Lord going to melt. They skin.
I already got
them. Get them again. The Most High is going to destroy them. Their skin is going to melt away off their face. Just like the scripture says. fucking weirdos that way. I'm gonna laugh when the Lord start killing these fools, man. It's gonna be a beautiful sight. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, here it is. Oh yeah, this is beautiful. Which one?
Which scripture is it? Zechariah 14 and 12. Yeah, 14 and 12.
Zechariah 14 and 12. Should be off. Man, look at this shit, man.
Fucking.
Look at this shit, man.
Fucking weirdos, man.
Zechariah 14 and 12. And this shall be the plague wherewith the Lord will smite all the people that have fought against Jerusalem.
So fought against Jerusalem means you going against the commandments of the Lord. Like these weirdos over here, okay? The Lord's going to destroy you. Keep going.
Their flesh shall consume away while they stand upon their feet, and their eyes shall consume away in their holes, and their tongue shall consume away in their mouth. And it shall come to pass in that day that a great tumult from the Lord shall be among them, and they shall lay hold every one on the hand of his neighbor, and his hand shall rise up against the hand of his neighbor.
Oh, so you're gonna have, soon there's gonna be all out chaos in the streets. Like we said, when Russia start dropping the missiles on America, all you wicked fools out here, you're gonna get destroyed. You're gonna get melted.
A fat dragon.
Yeah, a fucking fat drag queen. It's fucking disgusting, man.
Fucking fat dragon. Fucking swine eating dragon.
Yeah, a big fat hog. A fucking nasty fucking wildebeest.
A walking abomination.
Fucking filthy ass America. Only in America. Only in America.
Yeah, America is a nation of faggots and weirdos. It's the kingdom of Satan. And according to the Holy Bible, the one you call God is going to destroy America. He ain't going to destroy all you faggots in it. All right, you all going to get burned up. All you faggots, you're going to get put to death. That's all there is to it. You're going to get put to death, and you're going to get burnt the fuck up. All right, that's all there is to it.
Isaiah 1 and 3.
I was just going to Isaiah. Go ahead.
The ox knoweth his owner, and the ass his master's crib. But Israel does not know.
Yeah, because an animal has more sense than you people. Keep going.
My people does not even consider.
Yeah, they don't give a damn about them. Keep going. That's why everybody out here celebrating Halloween. A Halloween go back to the ancient festival of the harvest, where they would worship Baal, and they would sacrifice their children to Baal, praying that they would get a plentiful harvest, and they'd get a good harvest, and they'd get a Baal, the devil, would give them enough food so they can make it through the winter. That's what Halloween's about. That's what Halloween's all about, the children. You know what I'm saying? Because back in the ancient world, but even still to this day, on Halloween night, they sacrifice children to the devil. So when you send your children out trick-or-treating, you take them part in a satanic ritual, and you putting satanic vibrations into the ether.
Dumbasses.
You know what I'm saying? And they use all that energy. And then they use all that energy from this ritual you call Halloween, and then they summon up demons with it, and they put spells on your ass.
They basketball players.
Sinful nation, a people laden with iniquity.
Yeah, so these fools are laden with iniquity.
A people laden with iniquity, a seed of evildoers.
And this is talking about Israel too. It's talking about the Lord's own people. All right, this is talking about Israel. They ain't fucking right.
Right there. Fucking be blind to this shit. A seed of evildoers, children that are corruptors. They have forsaken the Lord. They have provoked the Holy One of Israel unto anger.
Yeah, so you celebrate Halloween, yeah, you provoke the Most High to anger. That's like literally worshiping Satan. Literally. They don't get no more Satan. They call it, tonight is the, what, October 30th? In Detroit, they call it Devil's Night. And they actually call it the Devil's Night. so?
You know, a child don't know fucking better, man.
Yeah, that child thing is fun and cool.
Yeah, they like watching Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, so they go out and get a Turtles costume. Like, yeah, they think it's cool. Like, oh, I'm my favorite turtle tonight.
Yeah, they dress up like Raphael, Michelangelo, or a Power Ranger or some shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? They think that's cool. That ain't cool, man. Now, you can dress up like a turtle on another day.
Yeah, any other day is cool.
They have provoked the Holy One of Israel into anger. They are all going away backwards.
Yeah, y'all, America's the most backwards country on the face of the earth. Okay? You big faggot. Drive by scoffing. So this is the most backwards ass country. In America, they got women got rights. A woman should have no rights. A woman is a piece of property, okay? Property, a man's possession, all right? A woman ain't supposed to be in no position of power, but in America, you got women senators, women congressmen, you got women police. That's what kind of joke is that? A woman gonna pull you over and she gonna put you in handcuffs? She get knocked the fuck out, you know what I'm saying? And they do get knocked out. A big fucking joke, man. That's right. Do you know when even when America was first formed, women were not allowed to own property. They weren't allowed to walk down the street without a permission. You know what I'm saying?
Escort by man.
And but now the women walk around freely. They can commit adultery, which is against the laws of the Bible. They walk around half naked, showing their titties and camel toe. You got women walk around showing their titties. They got tattoos on their titties. You hoes are disgusting, okay? And the Lord's gonna kill you.
Hoes.
A bunch of hoes and bitches. That's all y'all are. Hoes and bitches.
1 Timothy 2:12. But I suffer not a woman to teach.
So yeah, they got women as they preachers in their churches now. And the Bible said a woman's not supposed to teach.
Nor to assert authority over the man.
So a woman is supposed to have no authority. But here it is in America, you got women senators. What's that bitch, Congressman Michelle Bachmann? Some of your greatest leaders is, what's that bitch, Sarah Palin? Dumbass hoe, that's what she is, a dumbass hoe.
Slut.
You got Hillary Clinton, that dyke bitch. You know what I'm saying? Y'all gonna let them rule over you. And you wonder why shit's so bad.
But I suffer not a woman to teach, nor to assert authority over the man, but to be in silence.
So, yeah, a woman has no say-so. So, only a goddamn fool and a faggot-ass bitch let a woman rule over him. But see, the so-called Jew is the one that controls the earth. The so-called Jew, whose true name is Esau, they know that a woman's not supposed to be in power. So they're the ones who was behind the women's liberation movement, was a so-called Jew. And they knew that they could take away the power of the man by putting women in positions of power. You know what I'm saying? The so-called motherfucking synagogue of Satan.
You need a water? I got an extra one.
Oh, I'm gonna get that Ricola.
7 answers submitted, 7 answers.
I got a scripture. I got a scripture. Isaiah, we'll get back to that in a second. I just want to get this real quick. Isaiah 3:10, actually 3:9. The show of their countenance doth witness against them. They declare they sin as Sodom, they hide it not. So Sodom, the Lord destroys Sodom and Gomorrah because there's a bunch of faggots and adulterers and adulteresses. And America got the spirit of Sodom and Gomorrah on it. Ain't nothing but faggots, adulterers, women, bitches running their mouth. Okay, in the kingdom of heaven, if a woman runs their mouth to a man, she getting punched in their face. And that's all there is to it. She gonna do your ass like Ray Rice. All right? Well, when Ray Rice knocked that bitch out, that was an act of God. Okay, that bitch was talking shit, and he knocked that bitch the fuck out.
Ow.
You know what I'm saying? You gotta give credit where credit's due.
That's right. Round of applause.
Yeah, we give a thumbs up to Ray Rice.
We should send him a certificate.
Thumbs up to OJ.
Yeah, thumbs up to O.J. Simpson. Y'all want to talk about American heroes? O.J. Simpson is a great American hero. Because that bitch Nicole Simpson committed adultery, so she put that bitch to death, and she put that Jew devil Ronald Goldman to death right along with her. So when O.J. Simpson killed that bitch, that was beautiful, okay? Because the Holy Bible says, if you commit adultery, you get put to death. Hey, get that scripture. Oh, go ahead. We're going to prove it. The Holy Bible says adultery is punishable by death. But in America, adultery is legal. Adultery is encouraged. All the Hollywood TV shows, all the Hollywood movies you watch that are made by the so-called Jew, the devil, and the so-called Jew's the devil, all right? And all these Hollywood movies you watch, they encourage adultery, all right? They encourage homosexuality. They encourage blasphemy. All right, that's fine, whatever you got. I'm gonna read this while you're getting that. Isaiah 3:9, the show their countenance doth witness against them. So when you got a faggot walking down the street, they testify against themselves. All right, when you got a woman walking down the street half naked, showing her titties and camel toe, you testify against yourself. Said they declare their sin as Sodom, they hide it not. Woe unto their soul, for they have rewarded evil unto themselves. Say ye to the righteous that it will be well with them, for they shall eat of the fruit of their doings. Woe unto the wicked, it shall be ill with him, for the reward of his hand shall be given him. So what's the reward of an adulterous woman? It's death. What's the reward of a faggot? It's death.
Deuteronomy 22:22. If a man be found lying with a woman married to an husband, then they shall both of them die.
So yeah, the Bible says you commit adultery, you gotta die. All right, you gotta get put to death. But in America, an adulterous woman will leave her husband, have five different baby daddies, and she get rewarded with child support. Well, here it is, the Bible says you're supposed to get put to death. So you see, the reign of the liberal whorish woman is coming to an end real soon. All right, and if you women being hoes, you need to stop being a hoe. All right, but you ain't gonna listen. You gonna keep being a hoe, you gonna keep popping your pills, keep dressing like a slut, keep running your mouth, and then the Lord's gonna put you to death. And that's gonna be the end of you.
If a man be found lying with a woman married to a husband, then they shall both of them die, both the man that lay with the woman and the woman.
Oh, and that's what O.J. Simpson did. Because O.J. Simpson, Nicole Simpson, her last name was Simpson. That was O.J. Simpson's property. And he loved that woman. So when she cheated on him and got with that Jew bastard, he put their asses to death. Because that was the spirit of the Lord jumped on O.J. Simpson, and he put that adulterous whore to death.
So shalt thou put away evil from Israel.
Yeah, and Nicole Simpson, that was the last time she ever committed adultery.
Yeah,
and she ain't gonna do it no more. The bitch ain't breathing.
Job 34:21. For his eyes are upon the ways of man, and he seeth all his goings. Oh, no, no, let me start up. In a moment shall they die, and the people shall be troubled at midnight and pass away, and the mighty shall be taken away without hand. For his eyes are upon the ways of man, and he seeth all his goings. There is no darkness, nor shadow of death, where the workers of iniquity may hide themselves.
Yeah, yeah, so y'all can't hide from the Most High.
Zoom in on that.
Not lay upon man more than right, that he should enter in judgment with the Most High. He shall break in pieces mighty men without number and set others in their stead. Therefore he knoweth the works, and he overturneth them in the night, so that they are destroyed.
Oh, the Lord said he come like a thief in the night. When you least suspect it, that's when the Lord going to fuck you up.
He striking them as wicked men in the open sight of others because they turned back from him and would not consider any of his ways.
That's right, because the Lord going to make a mockery of you fools.
So that they caused the cry of the poor to come out unto him.
Cry of the poor.
Yes, sir. And he heareth the cry of the afflicted.
We out here crying right now. And we afflicted. Go ahead.
When he giveth quietness, who then can make trouble? And when he hideth his face, who then can behold him? Whether it be done against a nation or against man only. That the hypocrite reign not, lest the people be ensnared.
Yeah, we ensnared right now, because right now the hypocrite's reigning. Go ahead.
Surely it is meet to be said unto the Most High, I have borne chastisement, I will not offend any more. That which I see not teaching thou me, if I have done iniquity, I will do no more. Should it be according to thy mind, he will recompense it, whether they refuse or whether they choose, and not I, therefore speak what thou knowest.
Yeah, so like this, yeah, so, the loud ass bunch, you can't think of that loud ass shit. Yeah, like the scriptures say, we gonna preach his word whether they hear or forbear, all right? We gonna tell you the truth whether you want to hear it or not, man.
They don't.
I mean, they definitely don't want to hear it. Most people don't want to hear it. Let me read the rest of this Isaiah. Isaiah 3:12. As for my people, children are their oppressors, and women rule over them. O my people, they which lead thee cause thee to err and destroy the way of thy path. They're like, we're going back to that, like, you know, America's a country of faggots when they got women in positions of power. They got women as their judges on the Supreme Court. They got women senators. They talking about they going to elect Hillary Clinton, or hermaphrodite for president.
This coming up to some election, midterm elections too.
Yep.
And you go around Columbus, you see all kind of advertisements, these bitches running for judges. I ain't seen none but women running, man.
Big
black bitches, white bitches.
That's an abomination, mm-hmm. Man.
Got their big ass postings everywhere, man.
Because a woman's easy to manipulate, too. Very easy. That's why the serpent, and you read the Bible in the book of Genesis, the serpent went to the woman because a woman's dumb as hell. They easy to manipulate.
Dumb as fuck.
So they love to get women in positions of a power there because they way easier to bribe than a man. Now, you know, got a lot of men, they might stand up on their morals. Which is very that. But all the politicians are sellouts, so, you know what I mean? You gotta be a sellout to be in the Congress and Senate to begin with. So your boy Rand Paul, he done sold out. He done sucked a Jew cock probably. He probably a goddamn Freemason. The people, well, there's a couple good ones in there. You know? Okay, you heard Rand Paul talks like a homosexual. Have you heard him talk? Talks like a big faggot, man.
Yeah, sounds just like him.
He sounds pretty gay to me. But that's their great hope, ain't it? They hoping on him.
That's crazy.
And that other dude with Ted Cruz. They say Ted Cruz is a great leader. He's always giving praise to the so-called Jew over there in Israel, the devil. So you know he ain't fucking right. Oh yeah, half the congressmen and senators are so-called Jews. John Kerry, Dianne Feinstein. Oh, they got a whole bunch of them right here. They're so-called Jews running the government. A bunch of these devils right here. Get them devils on camera if you can. All so-called Jews. Half the goddamn senator fucking Jews. Harry Reid's a fucking Jew.
That's why they're here. pass on that shit that supports Israel.
Yep. Does Israel get all their money? All them fake Jews over there in Israel, none of them, they don't fucking work.
Yeah.
Hey, they get all the American taxpayer pays for them, pays for their house, pays for their food, pays for their clothes, their cars, their drugs.
Waking up to him too. A lot of
them.
Except Americans.
He poor got a Macho Man shirt. Oh yeah. A Macho Man was an Israelite indeed, man. Yeah, he had the best mic skills in the history of wrestling.
He went to the same high school as us.
I thought he went to Groveport.
No, he went to South.
Sure. I think that was an urban myth.
Yeah. Nah, Tony used to rob motherfuckers with him in the alley.
Man, you believe anything Tony said? Old jump slap.
But he did go up from South
Carolina. Yeah, Macho Man, that Most High killed his ass. But yeah, he was definitely an Israelite. They said he got, because you know he ain't in the WWE Hall of Fame. Because Vince McMahon hates him, because I heard he was fucking Stephanie when she was a teenager. But he was getting all kind of.
What do you expect?
Yeah, I'd be fucking the bitch too. Hell shit.
Yeah. You know
what I'm saying?
Stephanie bad.
Yeah.
I like Stephanie, man. The big ass fake titties she put in.
Yeah, the big ass fake titties.
It was already nice, man.
Yeah.
I don't do that shit, man. Stupid ass things. Why is it stupid shit like that, man?
Oh, you think Stephanie is her?
Oh, fuck.
Vince McMahon? Hey, you never know, man.
Yeah.
You never know, shit.
Yeah, shit.
The Vince McMahon be talking shit too, though.
Yeah, I mean, this is so much, man.
You don't nobody like his ass either. Most of the wrestlers are Israelites, man. Because you got to have style and swagger to become a superstar in wrestling.
The superstar.
Like The Rock, that's a good example, is The Rock.
This shit, a better example we're using is like Stone Cold, because he don't look like an African.
Oh, can they call him a redneck? He's just a redneck hillbilly.
Yep, yep.
I bet he'll whoop your ass.
Right. Stone Cold.
Yeah, he'll go Stone Cold crazy on you,
Mick Foley.
Another example of somebody that don't look like the Israelite. You know?
Yeah, they say, oh, he's just a cracker. He going into slavery.
Black as shit, like, dark as fuck.
I bet if you took Stone Cold and put some black face paint on him, he looked like a black dude.
Like a nigga.
Yep. Straight up.
Yeah, you can't entertain like that unless you're in Israel.
Yeah, because Israel's...
Him and The Rock came at the perfect time, man. And that was the perfect...
That was that Rock.
One against another. That was the perfect combination of wrestling, man. Stone Cold and The Rock. There's no better era, man.
The Attitude Era is what
it
was.
Yeah, yeah. Right. Because it was kind of better back in the 70s and 80s.
But yeah,
the Attitude Era, you're right. They're rebellious, that, you know.
Yeah, that shit was
badass.
But
shit.
They was really biting off of ECW.
Really? I never watched that crazy
shit.
Oh,
but ECW
that's
had a.
Sick shit.
That's where the Dudleys came from.
Yeah, I know, yeah.
Mick Foley.
Terry Funk was laying it down. Terry Funk, just for the record, just so y'all know, in my opinion, Terry Funk is the greatest wrestler ever. And he's an Israelite. He's an Israelite. Terry Funk is a bad motherfucker. I love me some Terry Funk, boy. That motherfucker's bad.
Terry Funk, what's his name? That dude that worked with, that wrestled with The Rock and him, Nick Foley.
Nick Foley.
Nick Foley. He came from what you talking about?
ECW. Mm-hmm.
But he's doing that shit.
You can tell they all got the same ways. Cut the extreme with that cutting shit, man.
Yeah.
I mean, extreme with it, man. But Terry Funk, that was some sick shit. I could never watch the shit.
I like
that barbed wire shit. They're literally ripping their skin open, man.
They just go to show that's, Israel's only an Israelite can do that wrestling shit. Because just like the book of Genesis, it says that Jacob is stronger than Esau.
My boy Dusty Rhodes and
bad big faggot, man.
And, Dusty Rhodes and Terry Funk used to feud.
But Dusty Rhodes.
Dusty used to whoop his ass.
I was watching a YouTube video. I was watching a YouTube video of Dusty Rhodes doing a promo. And he was talking all that jive talk. And somebody on the comment board said, Dusty Rhodes is a nigga. They say he's a black man in white man's skin. And he talks just like a
nigga.
He is
an Israelite.
I mean, that's what I'm saying. But
you
got
some Israelites, got more swagger than others.
Let's go into that.
You know?
Because
Dusty had way more swagger than all the wrestlers. Shit, way more.
He did have a lot, even though he's
way
a,
more.
Even though he's a big faggot.
Yeah. He was one of the best promos. Him, yeah. Ric Flair.
Oh, Ric Flair.
Back then, you ever heard of Buzz? Woo! You ever heard of Buzz Sawyer?
I do. I know. I didn't watch
now,
him.
Now, anybody that's hitting what? Buzz Sawyer on YouTube, that was one of my craziest motherfucking favorite wrestlers, Buzz Sawyer.
I think I seen it.
Buzz Sawyer.
I ain't too familiar with him, though.
A crazy dude, man. Crazy dude. Buzz Sawyer. Yeah, you can't watch wrestling without liking Buzz Sawyer, man. If you don't like Buzz Sawyer, you don't.
I gotta go look him up.
Because he feuded, he had the bloodiest blood feud with Tommy Rich. This was back in the late 80s, going into the 90s, man.
Oh, damn, what is he, WCW?
Nah, NWA.
NWA?
NWA.
I feel like a retard now, man. Like, I'm a novice. I don't know nothing.
Well, I go a little bit further back in the wrestling, man.
Right, yeah, because I grew up a little bit after. I'm going to go check him out.
But, man,
I probably do know who he is.
I'm telling you, man, I guarantee you're going to love Buzz Sawyer. You're going to love Buzz Sawyer. You think you like Terry Funk, you're going to like Buzz Sawyer even more.
Why so?
Watch, I'm telling you.
I like all of them.
You want to talk about somebody that ran his fucking mouth.
That's why I love someone.
Oh, you know what? Let me just do it now, man.
I'll go ahead, get it out. That's Israel Spears, the shit talk. But you got a lot of assholes on YouTube. They're like black supremacists, and they'll say only black people are Israelites. And then you going off. The Lord gonna kill you. He gonna put you to death, okay? He gonna choke your ass with some barbed wire. He gonna ECW your ass.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I got a scripture. Now, I want y'all.
This is important.
I want these clowns like General Yohana. Give me some other ones. Even Nate, Nathaniel 7.
Nasty Nate.
Okay, you ain't gonna see nobody looking like Eminem up in his camp. You know what I'm saying? You know Eminem is obviously Israelite.
Don't bubble IT keep talking to be saved.
No, but he's teaching that Jake is say put it this way. That you got that dude from GOCC, Bubble Eye Blackfish. Say if he got a white dude in his camp that's actually an Israelite. He'll call him an Edomite, mm-hmm. and he'll be looking down on him, mm-hmm. but still trying to say he can kind of get saved.
Right.
So he's kind of smooth with his shit, but he don't make it too clear. He's trying to act like you're his brother, but you're not his equal. And the Bible says the first shall be last, and the last shall be first.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Well, I got a scripture. I want when you faggots to break this scripture down. General Yohana, Nathaniel 7. Or how about some of Nathaniel 7's goons? Because y'all watch our videos, you'll comment on our videos all the time. And every time I bring this scripture out, y'all run away and shut the fuck up. Let me read it. Revelation 7, and I bring it out every day. Every day. Revelation 7 and 9. After this, I beheld, and lo, a great multitude which no man could number. That's Israel. Israel's more numerous than the sands of the seashore, more numerous than the stars of heaven. After this, I beheld, and lo, a great multitude which no man could number, of all nations, kindreds, and people, and tongues. What does that mean? Of all nations? What does all nations mean?
All nations.
Does that just mean just a couple of the nations?
It definitely don't mean just Israel.
Does it just? Well, I know that, but this is talking about Israel scattered among all nations.
All nations. Chinese, Japanese.
They don't just mean
the Hamites.
It don't just mean a couple nations, does
right.
it?
It means all.
It means all nations.
All of them. Amongst Esau.
Amongst
the Edomites.
All right, we talk a lot of shit about the so-called Jews, and how they a bunch of devils, which they are, and they're the ones controlling Hollywood, the government. The news, that the so-called Jew prince of money, but we know some of our people are scattered among them Jews. That's something a lot of these clowns out there, they'll never teach that, because they're so proud, and they're so sure that they're better than everybody else. We ain't got that proud spirit, you know what I mean? Motherfuckers, oh, they so sure they're Israelite, and everyone else is a heathen. You know what I'm saying? That's a proud spirit, man.
Totally ignore the spirit.
Totally ignore the spirit.
Totally ignore them, whoever it is. Oh. may have understanding of the Bible, believe in the Lord.
Just like, that's like your boy Zabak.
Mm-hmm.
He, you watch, he got a proud spirit. He think he's the goddamn king of Israel.
Yeah, right.
Just so proud. The Lord's gonna fuck you up, man. He's gonna bring you low.
Break your shit down.
We'll put your ass in the camel clutch.
This bitch walking around with a room. A bathrobe.
She
just got a bathrobe.
She's gonna pull out a pipe and shit. She wants to start smoking. Ain't that how they do it with the bathrobe and the pipe?
Right, right.
These people are fucking a joke. Oh, go ahead. What you got there?
I'll bring it out. That's Buzz Sawyer.
Did it get loud? Hit him on camera. Oh, I've seen him before.
Yeah, Buzz Sawyer.
Who's doing the talking right there? Oh, that's before they had Terry Schiavone. Or whatever his name, Tony Schiavone.
World championship.
Get him on camera. Go sideways with it.
Oh, yeah.
There go Buzz Sawyer for your
ass. That's Buzz Sawyer.
Looks like Chris Benoit.
He does kind of know it. He looked like a crazy son of a bitch.
That could be Chris Benoit's dad.
He ain't crazy yet. I don't know. I'm going to look for one when he's acting crazy, though.
Yeah.
See his forehead.
You know, one of them happened to be my brother.
He was one of the bloody wrestlers.
And I want so this to say here what you did to my brother.
You're going to get copyright infringement.
Nah, they don't give a fuck about wrestling.
They don't do
it. Nah.
And he's playing like a dog I never seen play before. And for me to sit here and flesh and blood, his brother, the brother that I grew up with,
this summer, love
used
wrestling.
To play baseball with, used to go out front playing a little bit of hockey.
That's a nigga right there.
This is the example, man.
Oh, like, what about your boy Roddy Piper? That motherfucker was crazy.
The Scottish Scotsman.
The British Bulldogs. They weren't crazy, but they were white.
I never liked them, though.
They were Israelites.
The British Bulldog. And the Dynamite Kid.
Dynamite Kid has skills, though.
Yeah. Oh, Dynamite Kid came up with Bret Hart.
He came up. He got famous with Japan.
Both of them did, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, but the Dynamite Kid has skills.
Yeah, he did have skills.
Mm-hmm. But his Bulldog was just big and clumsy. Big and clumsy, slow, but buff.
Oh, but you know, the best promo, I know definitely an Israelite, is your boy Superstar Billy Graham.
One of my favorites.
Not Superstar Billy Graham. Yeah.
So just like he came right out the hood.
Right, straight out the hood, man. That's it. He probably from the tribe of Judah.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Talking that kind of shit.
Yeah, right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Your boy is too smooth with his shit.
Esau ain't never
gonna talk like that, man. Yeah.
He was one of the catalysts that used to make big.
Oh, you know, Hulk Hogan stole his whole style.
Yeah.
From Superstar.
Yeah, when they first started trying to market wrestling, he was one of the main keys.
Yep.
Billy Graham.
Talking all kind of shit. You know? I was watching one. He's like, I wake up in the morning, I run 20 miles or swim across the ocean. I swim across the Atlantic Ocean.
Yeah, he used to fill Madison Square Garden up, because that's where they used to mainly wrestle, at Madison Square Garden.
Oh, yeah,
they
Madison.
They filled that place up. I'm talking about Madison Square Garden went on. They would have to start doing the pay-per-view shit back then, man. Superstar Billy.
Look, here comes the basketball team.
He used to feud with the legend. Bruno Sammartino.
Oh yeah, I never really liked Bruno Sammartino.
Yeah, I didn't either.
I didn't really like
him. He went back to the 60s.
Yeah, because he's the one that took out the Nature Boy, the original Nature Boy. What's his name? He an Israelite too.
The Nature Boy.
You know what I'm talking about, the original one. That's who Ric Flair stole his whole shit.
Any of y'all got hops, man? Being that tall, man.
Yeah.
Oh, come on, I bet. No skills. This is for y'all too, man, because y'all Israelites, man. Actually, that's probably why y'all can play some ball. But, like I said, boy, OSU is more.
They just got marked.
Right, just got marked.
Oh, they ain't allowed to come out here, probably.
Mm-hmm.
No, your boy, what's him, your dude that came out here and talked to us, he was
Terrell Pryor.
Quarterback.
Terrell Pryor came out here humble.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? We was talking to him.
The fools he was with was.
They was talking to us. They was clowns, but at least they came up and listened, talked. You know what I'm saying?
You can tell they just got their tattoos done that day.
That was their time, wasn't it?
Yeah.
They was all up in the weed shop.
They just sold all their autographs, went, got tattoos, got some weed.
Yeah. I like Terrell Pryor. He's a good quarterback. Yeah, but fuck Ohio State football, man.
Basketball, too.
And basketball. The basketball team, y'all ain't never going to win a championship.
That's the day we before the day before the day or the day before they played the championship.
Yeah,
was out here.
We cursed the whole damn parade. And then they lost. We cursed their whole goddamn parade, bro.
Was that the day the dude was rapping New World? No, that we didn't know what that was.
I forget what that was.
Man, that day, that was one of the last few days Lil Guy came out with us. And that day, that parade.
Oh yeah, the bus came out like with all the players on it.
They got quiet out here because of us, man. They got quiet.
Oh yeah.